To admit, I'm a little surprised. We were scheduled to do an up-close interview, an opportunity to learn a little bit more about your personal life, your personal background, and you show up in character for the interview.
Mike, I'm never really showing up in character. This is the way I've been all my life, and this is the way it is every day.
Why the face paint? Why all the tattoos?
I started getting tattoos and painting my face for two reasons. One was because I was a big fan of underground music and hardcore punk rock and things like that, and I was also always ashamed of myself. I felt I always had to apologize to everybody for the way I was, and I was always intimidated by everybody because I came from such a poor family. And I was always ashamed of people looking at my face, so I thought I'd give them something else to look at.
I'm confused. Ashamed? This doesn't make sense to me.
It doesn't make sense why I have to be here and try to explain myself to somebody like you who's not going to get it anyways, you know? The people like you and everybody else in WCW are always trying to figure out who I am, and they want me always to talk about why I do this and that. You know, I spent my whole life on the street being criticized and ridiculed for the way I look and the things I believed in. And then you got somebody here like Sting, who's babied, and, you know, he paints his face, and he gets into character twice a week. And, you know, it's like another acting job for him. And, you know, he's pampered. And where I got to be like this every day of my life is something that really drives me crazy.
Influences that you may have had in your life, be it rock and roll or professional wrestling?
Well, I had a lot of influence with rock and roll and with pro wrestling. And I always thought it was great to mix them together because I always thought the dark side of... I want to say one more thing about Sting. He's always worried about his schedules, and he's trying to fit in time to come to work, and he has a hard time getting motivated. And you know, he's worried about all his movie appointments and taking care of his pets. So I thought I'd help him, I'd relieve him of some of that responsibility.
Taking care of some of his pets?
Yeah, this is Steve's. This is something I got last Monday, a little souvenir.
This crow, Steve's?
Yeah, this crow, Steve, you know, the actor, Steve Borden, Sting, Sting.
Mm-hmm.
So anyways, you know, I know Sting, he's busy at home gardening or babysitting his other pets or whatever he's doing. I know he's never really got out of the house much, so I want to enlighten him with a little story about rock and roll, a real famous story about the Ozzy Osbourne incident, the record signing.
Educate us.
Basically what happened in New York City, he went with his wife to RCA Records, and when they got in the room, once they signed the deal, they were gonna release 100 doves. But Ozzy grabbed one and bit his head off and spit it out on the record executive's lap. And the only thing that really bothered me was it wasn't documented on film and nobody really got to see that. So I'm thinking to myself that was a real important moment in rock and roll, and I think I would like to recreate something like that somehow.
On live television, is what you're talking about?
Yeah, on live television.
Please,
right here.
Please, you know, this is...
It was a great moment in rock and roll, and I know Sting just doesn't get that kind of stuff.
This isn't right.
Live TV.
It's a very uneasy situation for me at this point. It's very uneasy.
It's just rock and roll, Mike.
It's just too uncomfortable for me. I'm sorry. Just...
Oh! Come here. You've had so much darkness in your life, haven't you? Oh! You just shed a little bit of light into your life. I'm so tired of your pity party. Come here. Let's have our first cage match. Come here. Ah! Think it's funny? Huh? Ah! Come here, Ian.
Hey, Ian. Listen here, you don't have to be ridiculed every day of your life. I don't want to ridicule you. See, there's something about you that I kind of like. But you're just full of this pity constantly every day of your life. So listen here, bonehead. I can show you the way if you just listen to me.
Some frightful, horrible, scary moments that Mike Tenay used.